It's game day here in New Orleans, Louisiana, and the Zombies fans are really fired up, mostly due to the flamethrowers the SWAT team has used against them in the parking lot. Nothing like the smell of smoking ribs at the tailgate party.
Hey, Grim, I stopped by this voodoo hex booth some shrunken head guy had set up out there. Two hexes for $10. Put one on my wife's divorce attorney and the other on the kid at the coffee shop for not leaving enough room for my cream.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Los Scandalous Volts take on the New Orleans Zombies. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's a beautiful day for MFL football, at least in the booth with the AC, personal servants, and blood shield. Hi, Grim Blitzrow here with you, along with my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing that little hottie who works the deep fry at the concessions.
He said how, not who, you idiot, even if you got the answer right.
And it's first and 10. Calling a hot potato dirty trick. That'll wake you up, and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose!
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's first and 10. And the ball falls to the ground. That's incomplete.
He needs to throw it when a receiver can catch it. What's he doing?
And groundbreaking analysis as always there, Bricks.
Well, thank you. I do my part.
They're taking what the defense has given them. That's a 4-yard gain on the reception.
Hey, less than a wife with a headache.
Third down and 6. What a throw. That sonic blast just cleared the field. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim. Oh, boy.
And it's first and 10.
Practice.
And it's first and 10. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Second down and 10. He had it for a second there. third down and 10. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. For a kick this far, you just gotta kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim! It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And he just wrestles away from that.
Did you ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse. Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
And that is caught for a first down. First and 10. Oh, nice hit. Second down and 6. First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and 10. And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, like a haiku.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and 5. Threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. Normally that would be a first down, but he had a whole lot of ground to make up. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
And it's first and 10. Check the rule book. Is that a penalty?
Why would I have the rule book?
Love of fuck's sake.
They're back up here on first. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. That run is good for 9 yards. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. He is rolling thunder and pouring pain. It's a zap attack. Oh, and the defender knocked the ball out when he was in midair. It is a fumble indeed.
Fumble-Maji, the new game from Wilton Crabtree.
He's at the 20. He's at the 10. Touchdown. And he rumbles that one into the end zone. Nicely done.
I can't run like that unless it's coupon night at Taco Hell. He has better footwork though than me on account of not clenching his cheeks.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Picks up about 6 on the play. And that'll be 2nd down and 4.
I've seen this guy run through a brick wall. He loves pain. First down.
And it's 1st and 10. Second down in a very lot. And the defense puts one over on the quarterback with a sticky ball dirty trick. The only thing the QB can do now is run for his life. QB is saying his prayers. The defender says, I don't think so. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. A misfired punt will give the opposing team great field position. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball is down.
it's first and 10. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10.
Sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose. It's a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's first and 10. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grin, but my watch is a bit slow.
Second down and 6. The quarterback passes the ball, and he decides to throw the ball away. Second down in a mile. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And it's first and 10. Looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. That's a gain of 7 yards on the catch. Nicely done. The QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have one left. Third down and 3. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's Matt's stupsing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzales.
Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Oh, great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. Ballsy. Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But a good heads-up play there, getting it out of bounds. Better than throwing a pick. And it's first and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. for the Halftime Show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Well, the third quarter coming up. Bricks, this game has been a hot mess so far.
Yeah, kind of like the morning after eating hot chicken wings. It's a hot mess on the exit ramp, if you know what I mean.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. He should have had that one. Second down and 10. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peckerhead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Third down and, well, good luck. Sonic blast against the defense, and then to first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
First and 4. Second down and more than the QB would like. Four yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Third down and the punter is warming up. Man, are these guys greedy or desperate? Either way, they're going for two. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. He refuses to go down. He runs it for 3. First and 10.
The receiver runs away from the pass marker. That's That's a good clue that something's not right.
Second down and 10. The defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick. The quarterback can't dump it.
And now they're going to dump his ass.
Oh, he just got crushed. Third down and 9. Stuck to him like glue. Any field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And he punched his way out of that tackle. And it's first and 10. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and 5. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. Third down and 3. Punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And it's first and 10. And it's first and 10. Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. As good as a sack.
No, it ain't. When you get a sack, you get to hit the QB in the nuts.
Yeah, good point, Junior. Third down and forever. Great catch for a big gain.
But still not enough for a first. Even I'm frustrated, and I'm a team agnostic.
Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. The return man catches the ball and hit. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that freak go! He's unstoppable!
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score! He's at the 30. The 20! And this guy runs angry and runs hard. First down. They might consider calling a kill the ref play. Just saying. And this is it, first and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Bam! Oh, man, that's the end of his day. He might want to try hurling those traps next time. First down and a mile. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. Oh, man, he just got skewered by those spikes. That was bloody and disgusting.
Hey, anyone in the mood for a steak kebab?
Make mine rare. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Second down and a lot.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And that'll bring up third down and 7. And this guy's like a human cannonball. First down! First and 10. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Second down and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. This guy's going to get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and 10.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. They've called a zap attack. Welcome to Fumbletown, USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles. And like Brix's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. He's at the 40. The 30. They might catch him.
Move, you fat little mutant.
The 10. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Thank you. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. A great throw and a great catch, but sadly to the...
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yowling.
First and 10. Man, he's running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a first down. And it's first and 10. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about 8 on the play. Second down and 2. Only 2 minutes left in the game. Second down and 2. I hope you covered your ears, Bricks, because then he broke free and has open field in front of him. Extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. Looks like a pass, and it's bouncing right back to the QB. Oh, it's the sticky ball dirty trick.
Ah, pass the popcorn, Grim. Zoom in on his face, then his crotch. I want to see if he cries or pisses himself first.
Second down, and they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. Holy crap, he runs straight into a mutant trap and dies. Reminds me of my breakfast cereal, the old Nut Crunch. First, the quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that's it. That's their last time out. It's them against the other team and the clock.
Well, that doesn't seem fair. I'm going to throw a hammer on the field and even the odds.
From the folks. In the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. The defense looks hungry out there. The quarterback better watch himself. And that play didn't have a chance. The defense comes up with a big stop on fourth down. And it's first and ten. Running game is starting to click now. A pickup of eight on the play. The zombie showing no life at home go down in defeat.
I used to date a zombie, Wim. She wanted to get into broadcasting and asked if she could pick my brain. What was I talking about?
They've got 99 problems, but a win ain't one of them.
That's right, Grim. Just like a bridge over troubled water.
Like a whole lot of Rosie.
The game's most valuable player is speaking about the victory now.
Hey, man, I was hanging on the middle now. Oh, yeah.
Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it. So